Good morning, this is Mrs. Hasner, and today we are going over Lesson 1, Ratios, Eureka Math, 6th Grade, Module 1, pages S1 through S4. Okay, so the first page, they show you an example. The co-ed soccer team has 4 times as many boys on it as girls, and we say the ratio of the number of boys to the number of girls on the team is 4-2-1. Okay, so we read that this is 4-2-1. Okay, and suppose the ratio of the number of boys to the number of girls on the team is 3-2-2. You could write it this way, and you can also write the number. Okay, so for this one, it'd be 3-2-1 with the word 2 in it. Okay. Okay, we're still on page 1. Here's example 2. Write the ratio of the number of boys to the number of girls in our class. If you were not in our class, use 10 boys to 7 girls for your ratio. Write the ratio of the number of girls to the number of boys in our class. If you were not in our class, use 7 girls to 10 boys for your ratio. So in other words, I want to see how you write it. Now, when you're doing ratios, it's always the first one that they say for your first number. Okay? So if this one should be 10 to 7, this one should be 7 to 10. Okay, this is page S2. Record a ratio for each of the following examples the teacher provides. So if you were not in class, I just made pictures for you and to help you do your ratio. So example, this one, you have 2 dogs to how many cats? And it's 6 cats. So you can write it this way or this way. Okay, 2 to 6 or 2 to 6. So for number 1, you count the bananas. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it'd be 7 to how many apples there are? 1. 7 to 1. Whoops, I helped you with 1. You're welcome. Page 2 continued. So go through these and just put your answers in the boxes. Okay, so page 2 continued. Exercise 1. It says, my own ratio compares blank to blank. My ratio is blank. So you're going to make up your own. You could say 2 flowers to 1 vase and 2 to 1, okay? Don't use my example, use your own. Exercise 2, using your own words, describe a ratio that represents each ratio listed. So they start off 1 to 12. So you might say this is an example one of the students said, and I thought it was cute. 1 cat lady to 12 cats, okay? So you go ahead and finish through F. And then your homework. Number 1, at the 6th grade school dance, there are 132 boys, 89 girls, and 14 adults. So for A, they want you to write the ratio of the boys to the number of girls. So they said boys first, so put that number first, and then either put the colon sign, the 2 dots, and then put the number of girls. Okay? Or you could write it the number of boys and the word 2, T-O, and 89 girls. So go ahead and do the rest of this. This tells you to write the same ratio using another form for A. So in other words, if you use the colon for this one, then use the word 2 in between for this one. And you're going to do the same for C and D. And number 2, in the cafeteria, 100 milk cartons were put out for breakfast. At the end of breakfast, 27 remained. Okay, so it asks you, what is the ratio of the number of milk cartons taken to the total number of milk cartons? Okay, so you have the total number of milk cartons, and they told you what was left, but they didn't tell you how many were taken. So you have to do a math problem. First, you have to subtract 27 from 100 to find out how many were taken first. And then you could do your ratio for it, okay? So they ask you the ratio for the number of milk cartons. So milk cartons would be first to the number of milk, the total number of milk cartons. And then B, it says, what is the ratio of the number of milk cartons remaining to the number of milk cartons taken? So remaining they gave you, to taken they gave you as well. Oh, no, they didn't. You subtracted it. So whatever your number was, when you subtracted 27 from 100, that's how many were taken. Okay? So you can do that. And then C, choose a situation that could be described by the following ratios and write a sentence to describe the ratio in the context of the situation you choose. So they gave you an example. They said 3-2, when making pink paint, the art teacher uses the ratio 3-2. For every 3 cups of white paint she uses in the mixture, she needs to use 2 cups of red paint. Okay, so you make up A, B, and C. And I think that's it. Okay, thank you.